Diminutive but deadly, the Skinks of the Seraphon are small but agile hunters who wield a surprising amount of power. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint those Skinks up to battle-ready standard using the classic painting method. We'll use very few paints and super quick methods to make sure you can get your units on the table in no time at all. Now, the first thing we've already done to prepare our model for painting is to undercoat it with Grey Sear spray. And once that's dry, we're going to be using Baharoth Blue all over the model to paint the skin first. For this, we're using our large base brush, so let's get straight to it. So here we're going to take a bit of paint out of the pot and put it onto the palette here. Now, it's a bit unusual using Baharoth Blue as a base coat like this because it's a layer paint, but it's actually the right paint to use because it's a nice bright colour that matches the Skinks on the front of the box. We're actually thinning it down with a touch of water here onto our palette just to help it flow onto the model a little easier. Then onto the model, we're just going to put it all over the skin like so. Now we're actually going to be painting just about the entire model here, so you can afford to be quite messy. Just make sure you're hitting all areas of the skin like so, all over the entire model. Excellent, perfect like this. Once you've covered the entire model, we move on to the next stage. So there we go, we've covered the miniature here with Baharoth Blue. You can see it's covered all of the flesh with that colour. We've also been a bit messy and gone on to other areas of the miniature, but that's not a problem as we're going to tidy those up later on. Okay, so now it's time to move on to the rest of the details on the miniature. We're going to start off by painting the scales of our skink with Thousand Suns Blue. Then we'll paint the shield with Lupercal Green. We'll pick out the weapon with Corvus Black, the gold bits with Retributor Armor, and then we'll use Avalon Sunset to paint our skink's eyes. First of all, that's Thousand Suns Blue onto the scales, and for this we're going over to our medium layer brush. So let's get straight to it. So here we're going to take a bit of paint from the pot and add it to our palette like this. Again, we're going to add a little bit of water here just to make sure the paint is thinned down enough to flow onto the model nicely. Perfect. We're also going to make sure our brush is nice and pointy by very carefully just putting in a straight line on the palette like so. Great. Now, onto the miniature, we're going to very carefully paint it onto our skink's scales like so. To be very careful here, to make sure you're painting just the scales here, try as hard as you can not to hit any areas of the flesh. Don't worry if you do, you can always go back later on and tidy that up. And once the scales are painted, we'll move on to the next stage. Next up, we're painting our Skink's shield with Lupercal Green. Again, we've slightly thinned this down to help it flow onto the model here, so you might need a couple of coats to get a really solid colour. Next up, we're picking out the whole weapon and the claws of our Skink with Corvus Black. Next up, we're picking out the gold detail on our Skink here. We're painting the bits of gold on the weapon here, and also look out for the bits of jewellery our Skinks wear as well. So you can see he's got a bangle here. Your Skink might have bracelets around his wrists or his legs, make sure you pick those out too. Next up, we're very carefully picking out our skink's eyes with Avalon Sunset. Be very careful here, try as hard as you can to be neat and don't hit the skin, but if you do, don't worry, you can always go back and tidy it up later. And there we go, that's most of the base coat applied onto our skink. Up next, it's time to apply a wash all over the entire model. We're going to be using Drakenhof Nightshade for this. So grab your medium shade brush and let's get straight to it. Now, we're going to take a bit of paint out of the pot like so and onto our palette. Here, we're going to be thinning it down quite a lot with water. So add a little bit of water here, a bit more. There we go, that's perfect. Then, onto our skink miniature, we're just going to apply it literally all over the entire model. So everywhere, the skin, the scales, the weapon, the gold, the shield, literally the entire model is going to get coated with this watered down Drakenhof Nightshade. It'll take a little while to dry, maybe about 10 to 15 minutes, but once it has, we'll move on to the next stage. And there we go, the Drakenhof Nightshade has dried all over our skin, giving this really cool look. Alright, there's one more detail left to paint on the model, and that's the teeth. For this, we're going to be using Morgast Bone as a base coat, then we'll use Seraphim Sepia to wash over the top of it. Again, we're going back to our medium layer brush for this, so let's get straight onto it. We're going to take a little bit of paint out of the pot like so, onto our palette, and then add just a touch of water, again to thin it down to help it flow onto the model a little easier. Then, onto the skink, we're just going to apply it very carefully onto these teeth. Now, our skink actually has teeth on the weapon here. It doesn't actually have teeth in its mouth. Some skinks do have teeth showing in their mouth as well, so make sure you're picking those out. But any teeth on the model, be it on the weapon or the skink itself, pick them out now with Morgast Bone. With our base coat done, we're now going to apply Seraphim Sepia Wash all over the Morgast Bone with a medium layer brush. So with all of the base coats and washes applied to our skink, our model is almost battle ready. There's only one thing left to do, of course, and that's to apply a textured base to our miniature. Now, for ours, we're using the texture paint Agrell and Badland, but you can, of course, use whichever paint you like for your miniature. As always with the texture paint, we're using our trusty Citadel texture tool, so let's get straight to it. Now here we're going to be taking a bit of paint from the pot using our tool like so. A nice big clump of paint, maybe a bit too much there, but that's perfect. Then onto the model, we're going to be applying it very carefully onto the top of the base like so. Now find a clear space on the base like this and apply it like that, then flip the tool round, use the thin end, just pat it down all over the top of the base, being very careful not to hit any part of the miniature. This will take about an hour to fully dry, and once it has, we'll paint the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. With the Gremlin Badlands dry and the base rim painted Steel Legion Drab, our Skink is battle ready. And there we go, that's how you paint Seraphon Skinks up to battle ready standard using the classic painting method. Something to remember here, that first base coat when you're painting the flesh can be quite messy, but after that try and be as neat as you possibly can with the other base coats, but don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back and correct them if you need to. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting!